Hello students, I am Sachit Prakar. Welcome to Cars Physics. We are continuing chapter number 2, Electric Potential and Capacitance, and this is my lecture number 28 on the chapter. So in previous lectures we have discussed numericals and combination of capacitors, and as I have discussed with you that there are different methods, there are different concepts to solve for equivalent capacitance in case of combination of capacitors, and I have divided the methods into several parts. In part 1 we have discussed some fundamental numericals, and also we have discussed different methods, means how we'll use connecting wire of zero resistance, then how we'll find equivalent capacitance. Also we have discussed potential method to find equivalent capacitance, okay, and we have discussed how to apply Kirchhoff's law to find equivalent capacitance. And in previous lecture, means in part 7 of the discussion, we have discussed how to apply the balance condition of Wheatstone's bridge to find equivalent capacitance, okay. So in previous lectures we have in part 7 we have discussed application of balance condition of Wheatstone's bridge to find equivalent capacitance. Okay, so if the Wheatstone's bridge is balanced, as we have discussed, suppose this is combination of capacitors 4, that's C1, this is C2, this is C3, this is C4, and this is C5. Okay. And finally, connected between the terminals of a cell. Okay, if C1 is equal to left 2C, C3 is equal to, okay, we have taken C2, this is C3, this is C4, okay. C1 is equal to 2C, C2 is equal to 4C, and similarly, C3 is equal to 4C, C4 is equal to 8C, then C5 is equal to 5C, okay. Then the ratio of C1 to C2, means here, the ratio of C1 to C2 is equal to ratio of C3 to C4. 2 by 4 means 1 by 2, 4 by 8 is also 1 by 2. Then this is the balance condition of Wheatstone's bridge. In that case, potential of these two points will be same, means this capacitor will not store any charge, there will be no flow of charge, so this capacitor is disconnected and removed. And finally we may calculate the equivalent capacitance. These two are in series, these two are in parallel, then finally these two branches are in parallel. These two are in series, these two are in series, means C1, C3 in series. So equivalent capacitance C1, C3 divided by C1 plus C3. So C2, C4 in series, equivalent capacitance C2, C4 divided by C2 plus C4. And finally, these two, means combination of these two and combination of these two, means these two branches, this branch and this branch, are in parallel. Just we have to add these two to find equivalent capacitance, as we have discussed. So in this lecture, we'll discuss how to find equivalent capacitance in case of combination of capacitor if there is Wheatstone's bridge, combination of 5 capacitors, but it is not balanced. Means unbalanced Wheatstone's bridge. Okay, unbalanced Wheatstone's bridge, combination of capacitors. How to find equivalent capacitance of combination of capacitors in case of unbalanced Wheatstone's bridge. See, here, this is C1, this is C2, 2C, so ratio C and 2C is 1 by 2, and this is C3, this is C4, ratio of C3 to C4 is 2C divided by C is 2:1. So ratio of C1 to C2, this is C1, this is C2, 1 by 2, ratio of C3 to C4 is 2:1, which is not same. So condition is not satisfied. So this is unbalanced Wheatstone's bridge. Then how we'll solve it? First, I will show you the method, means applying conservation, the concept of law of conservation of charge and potential difference. How to take, how to find equivalent capacitance using law of conservation of charge and potential difference between A and B or B and A. Okay. So that will be lengthier. So finally, I will show you a very short method. Okay. So we can solve this numerical in some 1.5 minute also, if you remember the formula. But first, learn the concept. Okay. So we have to find equivalent capacitance. This point is A, this point is B. Potential difference is delta V. Let potential of positive terminal is V. And as we have discussed, we may take potential of this terminal is 0, means this is our third, so potential is 0. So obviously, potential of B, A is V, potential of B is 0. Okay. Now, let's take how the charge is distributed so that we can apply law of conservation of charge. Okay. So, these two plates or any plates of capacitors are initially neutral or uncharged. Now, circuit is complete. So, these two plates are connected to positive terminal. So, just apply our previous concept. So, electrons will get removed from these two plates and will be attracted towards positive. So, accordingly, these two plates will get positively charged. Okay. Let total charge flow, means conventional flow of charge, is Q, positive. Okay. This Q is divided into two branches. Let this is Q1 and this is Q2. Okay. Then, if Q charge, if we consider conventional flow of charge is Q from positive terminal, and finally, this will be also Q. Okay. This is also in accordance with law of conservation of charge. Whatever charge we do assume, means conventionally we may take Q, then that much of charge must enter through negative terminal. So, this charge is Q1, this charge is Q2. Accordingly, this plate is positive, Q1, this plate is negative, minus Q1, this plate is positive, plus Q2. This plate is negative, minus Q2, as you know, this is positive, inner side is negative, this is positive, inner side is negative. So, flow of charge will be again plus Q1, bound induced charge minus Q1, free induced charge plus Q1, so flow of charge will be plus Q1. And here, from this plate, flow of charge will be Q2. So, this is a junction or node, this is a junction or node. So X, Y are two junctions or two nodes, then charge will get divided. If this flow of charge is Q1, then Q1 will be divided into two parts. Or if this charge is Q2, flow of charge is Q2, then Q2 may get divided into two parts. But which charge will get divided? Which charge will get divided? Charge flows from high potential to low potential. Potential is directly proportional to charge. If magnitude of Q1 is more than that of Q2, then division of charge will take place from X. This is a branch, this is a branch. Or if magnitude of Q2 is more than Q1, then this will be at high potential. Then this Q2 means Q2, flow of charge Q2, this is minus Q2. Flow of charge is Q2, will get divided into two parts, okay? Then, from which point, either from X or Y, from which point division of charge will take place, that depends upon potentials of X and Y or magnitude of charge, since potential directly proportional to charge. So, we don't know. We don't know whether Q1 greater than Q2 or Q2 Q2 greater than Q1, we don't know. Let's assume Q1 greater than Q2, so flow of charge is Q1, it will get divided into two branches. Okay, see, if Q charge, conventional flow of charge is Q, then here also conventional flow of charge will enter through this negative terminal. Then for this junction A, total charge is Q, which is divided into two branches Q1 and Q2, then Q is equal to Q1 plus Q2. Okay, Q is equal to Q1 plus Q2. As per law of conservation of charge, total incoming charge is Q, total outgoing charges are Q1 and Q2, so sum of incoming charge is equal to sum of outgoing charge as per law of conservation of charge. So Q minus Q1 minus Q2 is 0. Q minus Q1, incoming charge positive Q, minus Q1 minus Q2, outgoing charges Q1, Q2 is 0. So Q is equal to Q1 plus Q2. So this Q will also be equals to Q1 plus Q2. This is the basic thing. Okay, Q is equal to Q1 plus Q2. So here Q, here also Q. So obviously just see and think about symmetry of the circuit. Symmetry of the circuit is very important while solving the circuits, either the capacitive circuit or resistive circuit, whatever may be. You have to consider symmetry of circuit, you have to understand symmetry of circuit. Okay. Then if this charge is Q1, this is C, charge is Q1, this is C, charge is also Q1. This is 2C, charge is Q2, this is 2C, charge is also Q2. This is as per symmetry of the circuit. C, C, Q1, Q1, 2C, 2C, Q2, Q2. Again, the basic concept, Q is equal to Q1 plus Q2. Okay, so this plate is plus Q2, this is positive. This plate, inner side of this plate is minus Q2. Accordingly, this is inner side of first plate plus Q1. This is inner side of second plate minus Q2. So obviously flow of charge is, sorry, this is minus Q1. So minus Q1 minus Q2. Or you may assume from negative plate, negative charges are flowing. From positive plate, positive charges are flowing. Same thing. Okay. If you take from negative charge, you may take like this. This is plus Q. From negative charge, this is minus Q. Then this charge will be minus Q2, this charge will be minus Q1. As you take, so I have taken conventional flow of charge. So conventional flow of charge, so this charge is also Q. Q is equal to Q1 plus Q2. Okay. So we have divided the charges then about this charge. We have considered that Q1 is greater than Q2, X is at high potential, we have assumed. Then finally it will be concluded that actually from X or Y, from nodes X or Y, from which node there will be flow of charge, this will be decided after comparing the magnitudes of Q1 and Q2. Let's assume like this, this is Q1, flow of charge is Q1 and this is Q2. Then this flow of charge is Q1 minus Q2. Let's take this is positive, so accordingly this is negative. So this is Q2 minus Q1. So plus Q2 minus Q2, this is positive Q1 minus Q2, and this is minus into Q1 minus Q2 means Q2 minus Q1. This is negative. Or you may take like this also, minus into Q1 minus Q2, you may take like this. Okay. Now, we have taken Q is equal to Q1 plus Q2. Now, these three plates are forming an isolated system. Again, these three plates are forming an isolated system. Okay. Is it clear? 1, 2, 3. Initially, these three plates were uncharged. Net charge of these three plates was 0. Okay. Even after it is connected in a circuit, then total sum of charges will be 0 as per love, conservation of church. Okay. This is the concept. Now, let's apply Kirchhoff's law. Means circuit law, loop law. In a closed path of circuit, total change in volt or total change in potential is zero. Let's consider the circuit. This one. You may take clockwise or you may take anticlockwise. I am considering the closed loop or closed path of circuit. Let's take like this P, X, Y, M, P. P, X, Y, M, P. P, X, Y, M, P. This is a closed path of circuit. In a closed path of circuit, total change in potential is zero. But we have to obey the sign convention. We have to obey the sign convention. What we have discussed? From high potential to low potential, from high potential to low potential, we'll take negative. Accordingly, from low potential to high potential, we'll take positive. Okay, from high potential to low potential, potential decreases, take negative. From low potential to high potential, potential increases, take positive. Or vice versa. Okay. Let's take the usual convention what we have already taken. Then from P to X, we are moving from P to X. This is high potential and this is low potential. Okay. So this is high potential, this is low potential, from positive to negative. From positive to negative means from high potential to low potential, potential drop. C is equal to Q by V and V is equal to Q by C. Okay. So here potential drop is minus. From high potential to low potential, positive to negative, charge is Q1, capacitance is C. Charge is Q1, Q by C. Charge is Q1, capacitance is C. Px. Then from X to Y, we have assumed that division of charge takes place from X, means X is at a high potential. So this plate is positive, this plate is negative. Again we are moving from X to Y, means from high potential to low potential, from positive to negative, let's take minus. So here charge, Q by C, here charge is Q1 minus Q2, capacitance is 2C. We have moved from P to X, then from X to Y, then from Y to M. This is negative, this is positive. Y to M, first negative, then positive. Then while moving from Y to M, then first low potential, then high potential. So sign is positive from low to high, then plus charge is Q2, capacitance is 2C. Okay. So symmetry of charge, this is Q1, this is Q1, this is Q2, this is Q2. You may consider this circuit also, X, Q, N, Y, X, or you may take any circuit you may take, but here you may take the whole path, P, X, Q, N, Y, M, A, P. You may take this circuit also, any closed path you may consider. Okay, then total sum is zero. From P to P, P to P, P, X, Y, M, P. Okay. Then total change in volt is zero. Then we will solve it now. Okay. What we will get in solving? Minus Q1 by C. This is minus. Minus Q1 by 2C. This will be plus Q2 by 2C. Okay. 2C. Plus Q2 by 2C is equal to 0. Minus Q1 by C, minus Q1 by 2C, plus Q2 by 2C, plus Q2 by 2C. This is the result. So now we'll solve it. To get relation between Q1 and Q2. Q1 and Q2. See. LCM 2C. Then this is minus 2Q1. Okay, this is minus Q1, okay, this is plus plus q2, this is plus plus q2 is equal to 0. Then here minus q1, 2q1 minus q1 means minus 3q1 plus 2q2 is equal to 0, cross multiply 2c, okay, then what we get? 2q2 is equal to 3q1, 2q2 is equal to 3q1, so accordingly q1 is equal to 2 by 3q2, q1 is equal to 2 by 3q2, or you may take q2 is equal to 3 by 2 q1, okay, q1 is equal to 2 by 3q2, or q2 is equal to 3 by 2 q1, okay. So we have taken a closed path of circuit PXYMP. Now, to have to get potential difference between point A and point B. Between point A and point B, let's consider a path of circuit. Potential difference, potential of A is V, potential of B is 0, potential difference is delta V, or we may take it V. V minus 0, V minus 0 is V. Let's consider a part of circuit. You may take APXQB, AP, APXQB, or you may take AMYNB, AMYNB, any part of circuit, or you may take in reverse order, okay, BNYMA. Okay, you may consider any path, but let's take a path of circuit to get the expression of her potential difference. I'm erasing it. Is it clear? Is it clear? Okay. We have got the result. We have got the result. We may erase it now. Now, potential difference between A and B. Potential difference between A and B. Let's take the path I am taking in opposite order. B N, this is Y, B N Y, M A, M A, okay. I am taking this path. You may take A M Y N B, A M Y N B, or A P X Q B, whatever path. We are taking a part of circuit, a part of circuit. This is a part of circuit to get potential difference, to get potential difference. So here, potential difference, so we have to get potential difference. Potential difference is V, delta V is V, V minus 0 is V. Then we are starting from B to A, we are starting from B to A. Then while moving from B to A, B to A, potential is 0 because there is no load, connecting wire has no resistance. Then from N to Y, from N to Y, negative to positive means from low potential to high potential, plus charge is Q1, capacitance is C. From low potential to high potential, or from negative to positive is positive. Voltage potential is Q by C, here charge is Q1, capacitance is C. From N to Y, then from Y to M, again from low potential to high potential, negative to positive, plus charge is Q2, charge is Q2, capacitance is 2C, okay. So one thing I have left, Q1 is 2 by 3 Q2, okay. Okay, okay. Then Q, do it here, Q is equal to Q1 plus Q2, to have total expression, this is now we will come to this point. Q is equal to Q1 plus Q2. So Q is equal to Q1 plus Q2. In place of Q1, we may put 3 by 2 into Q1. So LCM is 2. 2Q1 plus 3Q1, 5Q1. 2Q1, sorry. Okay, okay. 2Q1 plus 3Q1 is equal to 5Q1. So Q1 is equal to, Q1 is equal to 2 by 5Q. Q1 is equal to 2 by 5Q. In same equation, Q is equal to Q by Q1 plus Q2, to have Q1 Q2, we have got Q1, then Q2. Again, Q is equal to Q1. In place of Q1, we may put 2 by 5Q plus Q2. Okay. Then Q2 is equal to Q minus 2 by 5Q. Then again, LCM is 5. 5 minus 2, 3Q. So Q2 is equal to 3Q by 5. Okay. Just compare which one is more and which one is less. We have assumed that Q1 is greater than Q2. So flow of charge is from X to Y. X is at high potential, Y is at low potential. But it is now we got that. Now we got that Q1 is equal to 2 by 5Q and Q2 is equal to 3 by 5Q. And it shows that Q2 is greater than Q1, means flow of charge will from Y to X. So accordingly, this plate will be positive, this will be negative. This plate will be positive, this will be negative. So it will change now. This is Q2. Flow of charge is Q2 and this is Q1. So this plate will have charge Q2 minus Q1 and this plate will have charge minus into Q2 minus Q1. Okay. So flow of charge is from Y. So this is at high potential, this is at low potential, since Q2, flow of charge is Q2, flow of charge is Q1, Q2 is greater than Q2. Okay. We have got this now. Total potential difference between B and A is V, because point A is at potential V, point B is at potential 0, potential difference is V. You may take from A to B also. So taking from B to A, final potential is V at point A, minus potential at B is 0, so V. So V is equal to Q1 by C, V is equal to Q1 by C plus Q2 by 2C plus Q2 by 2C. Now Q1 is 2 by 5Q divided by C plus Q2. Q2 is 3 by 5Q divided by 2C. Is it clear? Then V is equal to Q by C. Bring it common, Q by C, Q by C. Then what we will get? 2 by 5 plus 3 by 10. Q by C, Q by C, bring it common. Okay. Then it will be 2 by 5 plus 3, 5 into 2, 10. Okay. Now we will get it. Q by C, LCM is 10. LCM is 10. Then this is 4 plus 3. And finally we will get Q by C into 7 by 10. Okay. Now, equivalent capacitance C is equal to Q by V. C is equal to Q by V. Again, another line. Let's erase this part. Okay. What we got? We got V. Means potential difference. So we got potential difference. Potential difference V, Q by C into 7 by 10. Okay. Then it is 7Q divided by 10C. This is potential difference. Is it clear? V is equal to 7Q by 10C. This is potential difference. Then equivalent capacitance is total charge divided by potential difference. Total charge divided by potential difference, then total charge is Q. Potential difference is 7Q divided by 10C. QQ get cancelled. QQ get cancelled. Then our result will be equivalent capacitance is 10 by 7 into C. 10 by 7 into C. If value of C is given, then use it here. So this is our result, and I think you are feeling this is linear. Then very short method. I'm showing you, just remember the formula, you can solve the numerical within a minute. Okay. You just remember the result, 10/7c, 10/7c, the same configuration, left. This is capacitance, C1 is C. Let's draw first. Okay. Now, the circuit is completed. The equivalent circuit, what we have already taken, the same thing. Okay. So, C1 is C. Let this is C2. C2 is 2C. Okay. This is C3. C3 is also 2C. So, let's take this is C2. Okay. Then this is C3. This is C4. Let's take, this is C4. This is C4. This is C5. Or you may take this is C5. Okay. This is C3. This is C2. And this is C4. The names are unaltered. The same name. C2C. Again. This is 2C, this is C. Okay. This was our circuit then. Just use the formula. Equivalent capacitance. C equivalent. What will be the formula? 2C1, C2 plus C1, C3 plus C2, C3 divided by C1 plus C2 plus 2C3. Just use this formula, you will find it easier, very easier, not easier, very easier. Okay. C3. Okay. C1, C2, C3, C4, C5. Okay. Then C equivalent 2. C1 is C, C2 is 2C, C1 is C, C3 is 2C, okay. Then C2 is 2C, C3 is 2C, divided by C1 is C, C2 is 2C, 2C3, C3 is 2C. Just solve it. 2 × 2, 4, 4C² plus 2C² plus 4C² plus 2C, 4C, 6C plus C, 7C. Okay. Then 4 plus 2, 6, 6 plus 4, 10. 10C² divided by 7C get cancelled. Then final answer is 10/7C. Again, same. But practically, you follow the previous method, maybe lengthier. All types of numericals can be solved if you use the first method. Okay, this is for this type, particularly for this type of problem. Okay. Thanks, children. Thanks for your support. Again, I will meet you in part 8 of the discussion with some new concept, solving the numericals based on combination of capacitors. Thanks.